Hello and welcome to a new edition of Eliphas Leary's Lectures About Magic. This time it's about gods and angels and egregores, mainly egregores. Because one of you left some very, very good questions in the comment section of my previous video about egregores. And that list of questions kind of forces me to make this video, and if you want to force me to make videos, ask me questions. And if you don't want to use a comment section to kind of ask me those questions publicly, send me a PM. If you don't know how to send a PM on YouTube, leave a comment that you want to send me a PM and I'll send you a PM. I love communication because communication is kind of what the internet is about. So, on to the questions. I will not answer these questions in the order they were given because some of them are too wonderful together. They offer the opportunity to explain some stuff that I want to explain. So, first question. Do egregores occur in nature without someone's intent or will? Yes. Does this tie in with Jung's definition of archetypes, and if so, how? Yes. Answer to both of these questions in a second after I wrote the third question off in this list, the last question. And is there a direct relationship to shamanism regarding this notion? Well, I assume that you're not talking about shamanism in its original sense, because shamanism is the religion of, or is a word for the religion in Siberia before the communists did pretty horrible thing, or the Stalinists did pretty horrible things to those shamans. That's one of the more forgotten atrocities of the Stalin regime. I take it that you mean the modern esoteric version of shamanism, and yes, there is a connection between what I would like to call the egregore mechanism and modern shamanism or religion in general. So let's just say priests instead of shamans. As I said in a previous video, or in part 1 of this volume 2 of the LAM videos, every human being has the ability to create gods. And by gods I also mean angels, demons, and all kind of fictional beings. Now, most people are not doing that consciously. In most cases you will find there is a priest, a religious figure of authority, who uses that ability in the believer, kind of by remote controlling that ability, by providing a template to the believer that the believer fills. And so the believer creates that being the priest tells the believer about, and starts believing in that being. You will find that mechanism in every religion. And there you have the answer to not intentionally creating that being as such a being. Most believers are not intentionally creating Jesus or Allah or whatever God. They are told to do so by some priest who knows how to exploit that ability. Well, in some cases the priest himself doesn't know that this mechanism works and is a believer himself or herself. So it's a funky topic. You ask the question, how does it affect people who are not aware of such things? Well, They run around and tell each other to believe in something. Sometimes they don't run around and they just take their belief as a completely unnecessary justification for a good life. That's okay. Well, you don't need to believe in some creature like God or Jesus or whatever to lead a good life. But if you feel the need to have such a being, go ahead. But we also know about the cases where believing in some being that quite probably does not exist leads to very terrible things, like witch hunts, suicides, bombings, and forcing other people to follow your belief. So the effects can be quite horrible. And I think making people aware of the mechanisms of belief may help with that, hopefully. So, next question. I'm curious on the topic regarding aliens. Are they a type of egregore? And if so, are they the spawn of Lam? By Lam, of course, you mean the being that appears in some parts of the Thelemic tradition. The being Crowley painted and didn't say much about. Kenneth Brandt wrote a bit more about Lam, and then some people started to create a cult of Lam and do magical workings with that being, and there you can see the dynamic and the evolution of an egregore, the evolution of a being that quite possibly doesn't exist. Very interesting stuff, but well, shit happens. And aliens, yes, of course, when you take a look at what people write about modern aliens, they are just projecting their wishful thinking on some beings. And there is literature, as far as I know. Well, I only have one book where it's mentioned. It's written by Peter Robert Koenig. The title is Abramelin and Co. So it's about the whole Abramelin thing in the Crowley heritage, the Thelemic traditions. And he points out, and well, I suspected so before I read that there are many parallels between the ancient belief in angels and the modern belief in aliens. You could say the modern belief in aliens and extraterrestrials visiting us in UFOs is a materialistic version of the old angel belief, where angels just needed a set of wings to flap around with to come down from the heavens. Nowadays they need spaceships, because we build spaceships, and why shouldn't aliens? There are many parallels about that, and if you want to read up on the thing with aliens and angels, because the last question I'll answer here, because it's the only question I didn't answer so far, that question is, do you know any place I can read up on the topic? This isn't a kind of general answer. To do your own research, the best basis for that is always, in my opinion, Wikipedia. There is an article about egregores, and of course, there are articles about aliens and angels and all that stuff. And each article in Wikipedia, on the one hand, should be read with a critical approach. On the other hand, these articles are excellent because they provide you with background, literature, and the different parts of the article are always backed up with references, and there are web links, so they provide you with a basis for your own research. Read the articles critically, take a look at the talk page, because there you can see which parts of the article are kind of dubious, and sometimes there's an edit war going on, and when you just open the article you don't see that there is an edit war going on, and maybe 5 minutes later the article is changed completely. So take a look at the talk page, maybe even at the history of the article. So Wikipedia, good source for your own research, good basis for your own research, and critical thinking is very, very important in everything, but especially when you get into the whole topic of magic, occultism and religion. Critical thinking is essential, and we live now in the information age, we have the internet, we have to be critical, and we can. So that's it for this video. I hope you had some fun, and as always, enjoy your time, enjoy your day, enjoy your life. See ya.